Good morning, students. Trust all of you are at home safe and taking care of yourself and your family. If you just recall what we did in the last class of the last regular class, evaluation of double integral using change of order. So why do we deal with change of order? Sometimes it becomes very difficult or difficult to evaluate the integration as it is given. So we go for change of order. So what do we mean by change of order? If they have given us the double integration function of x and y, dx, dy, these are x is a variable limit, x is a function of y, and y is constant limit. So we change it to a function of x and y. Here the order of the integration is dx dy with variable limits first and then with respect to constant limit. So we change it as dy dx, where y is a variable limit function of x and x is a constant limit. How to evaluate this? Using a strip, horizontal strip, changing to vertical, vertical to horizontal, we have studied. Now in this class, what I'll be doing is covering unit 4, evaluation of double integration by changing to different variables. So what is the meaning of this? Now let us assume that x is a function of u and v and y is also a function of u and v. Now we want to evaluate a double integral f of xy dx dy in a region R. So this is function of x and y. We are evaluating double integration, integrate with respect to x and y. How is this? A region is in the xy plane and the limits are of x and y. Now we want to change it to new variables. So what the procedure says? Double integral, a function of x and y is converted to a function of u and v. Jacobian du dv, now in a new region R. So what is new region R? This was a region in xy plane. The new region will be in the uv plane. Now here the limits will be of variables u and v. Now what does this stands for? J is the Jacobian. Jacobian of xy with respect to u and v. And we have seen this is dou x by dou u, dou x by dou v, dou y by dou u, dou y by dou v. Now here we are theoretical what we are doing. We are changing x, y to new variables u and v. Now, as particular cases, we are going to see to evaluate double integral by changing to polar coordinates. So what is this? As we all know, x is r cos theta in the polar, y is r sin theta, and x square plus y square is equal to r square. Now what we want? A double integral function of xy dx dy in a region R which is defined in the xy plane. R is a region in the xy plane. We want to take, now I shall say rxy to say that we are evaluating in a region which is in the xy plane. F of xy will be a function of r and theta, Jacobian j as we have seen the theoretical part, dr d theta in a new region R which is defined in the polar form r and theta. Here the limits are of x and y, and here the limits are of r and theta. Now, what does r stands for? As we have seen in the polar coordinates, this is a pole, this is an initial line, this we can say a polar curve f of r theta, and this is r radius vector, which varies from r is equal to 0 to r as a function of theta. We can say f of r theta is equal to c, or r is equal to f of theta. And what is theta? It is angle made by a radius vector with respect to an initial line. Now, what is a Jacobian here? XY with respect to r and theta. So, define this. Dou x by 2r, dou x by 2 theta, dou y by 2r, dou y by 2 theta. Now, hence, x is r cos theta. Hence, what is dou x by 2r with respect to r? It is cos theta. Dou x by 2 theta is minus r sin theta. Dou y by 2r is sin theta, and dou y by dou theta is r cos theta. Evaluate the result. So it will be r cos square theta plus r sin square theta, or I can say r. So what is this Jacobian J? Is r. When we change polar Cartesian coordinates to polar coordinates, so what we have to do is remember directly a result. As whenever I want to evaluate a double integral by changing Cartesian coordinate to polar coordinate, it should be function of r and theta. Dx dy is replaced by r dr d theta. So if we remember this, we can solve some examples, 4-5 examples which we have defined or which we have given in the notes. You just recall one example. What we have given is evaluate minus a to plus a, 0 to root of a square minus x square, root of x square plus y square dx dy by changing to polar coordinates. Now what it is? How I have to do? Now this is minus a to plus a, 0 to root of a square minus x square, root of x square plus y square dx dy. What theory says? A function of x and y must be written as function of r and theta. So what we have seen in polar coordinates? X is r cos theta, y is r sin theta. Hence, x square plus y square is equal to r square. Therefore, root of x square plus y square is equal to r. So, this root of x square plus y square is r. Replace dx dy by r dr d theta. So, this is ready. Now, we have to talk about the limits. Now, if you see here, 0 to root of a square minus x square means y varies from y is equal to 0 to y is equal to root of a square minus x square, and x varies from x is equal to minus a to x is equal to plus a. So as we have done in double integration in a region, just draw the diagram. So how it is now? Y is equal to 0 is x axis. Y is equal to root of a square minus x square. Y is equal to root of a square minus x square. Squaring and simplifying, I'll get it as x square plus y square is equal to a square. So draw a circle. So how y varies from y is equal to 0 to this? So we have y as a function of x. Therefore, we have a vertical strip. X varies from minus a. Now, if you see, this is a circle. A, B, C, D are points on the circumference of the circle. A with the coordinate a, 0, C with minus a, 0. X varies from minus a to plus a means this is x is equal to minus a, x is equal to plus a. So x varies from minus a to plus a. So what is the region where the integration is carried out? Is this. Okay. So now we have to convert this into polar coordinates. Now we shall draw the same region here. This. So we shall consider this as our initial line. This is the pole. So how does r varies? R varies from r is equal to 0 to the curve. So what is the curve here? X square plus y square is equal to a square in the Cartesian. X square plus y square is r square. R square is equal to a square, or r is equal to a. So r varies from 0 to a. And how does theta vary? So that total semicircle is covered. So theta varies from 0 to pi. So r varies from 0 to a. Theta varies from 0 to pi. So this is r into r, r square dr d theta. So it is a simple integration. You know how to evaluate the integration. Evaluate and check the answer. Any difficulty, you can always come back to me with doubts and you can give me a text message. This is the first example. So what is the second one? 0 to infinity, 0 to infinity, e raised to minus x square plus y square dx dy. So let me go little rough result. So what it is now? E raised to minus x square plus y square is r square. Dx dy is replaced by r dr d theta. So we shall always remember dx dy is replaced by r dr d theta when we are converting Cartesian to polar. Now x varies from 0 to infinity, y varies from 0 to infinity. So what is the, x varies from 0 to infinity, y varies from 0 to infinity. So here x varies from 0 to infinity, y varies from 0 to infinity. So this is the region where we are taking the integration. So if I go back to polar, how does r varies? R is equal to 0 to infinity. And how does theta varies? Theta varies from 0 to pi by 2. So how to evaluate this integration, or the detail of the calculation, is given in the notes, which is sent to you by WhatsApp. All of you might have taken down. You just see. And the answer is pi by 4. Any doubt in the evaluation of this integration? So let me know. So, okay. The third example I'll be taking as this. 0 to evaluate the integration by changing it to polar coordinates. 0 to a, 0 to root of a square minus y square, y root of x square plus y square dx dy. So as I said, dx dy is converted to or replaced by r dr d theta. This y is r sine theta. Root of x square plus y square is r. So how does limits? This x is equal to 0. So it varies from x is equal to 0 to x is equal to root of a square minus y square. Squaring and simplifying, x square plus y square is equal to a square. So it varies from x is equal to 0. So x horizontal strand. So x varies from x is equal to 0 to x is equal to root of a square minus y square. And how does y varies? 0 to a. So this is the region where the integration is carried out. So how are the limits here? Double integration, y is r sine theta, root of x square plus y square is r, dx dy is replaced by r dr d theta. So r varies from 0 to a, theta varies from 0 to pi by 2. Evaluate the integration, the details are given in the notes, and find out the result. That's all. This was just to give you idea about how we evaluate double integration by changing other variables, especially from Cartesian to polar coordinates. I hope all of you revise this. If any difficulties, give me a text message. Thank you.